Floyd Mayweather just did an interview with Jim Gray, and he told Jim he's in talks of returning into the ring, returning to fighting. Yeah.
I told you he's gonna come back next year to fight me.
But nah, what do you think about he's returning in September, and everybody's saying the name Danny Garcia?
He might. I mean, if it makes business for him, why not?
Are you excited?
He comes back. Then maybe I still get a chance to get in the ring with them. I mean, fuck, everybody is gonna be excited, not just me. Anybody, you know, 130 to 154, 160 is gonna be excited to know that Floyd is back. He might be back, you know, if the money, if the zeros are.
That doesn't make sense, right?
You know, zeros, you know, then yeah, he'll be back. It's a business. I mean,
okay, is him and Broner a bigger fight than him and Danny Garcia? They're both the same, or Danny's bigger than Broner?
I don't know. I think. I'll watch. I don't know. Broner has a lot of name. You know, Garcia has had a lot of victories and some.
No, straight.
Big, I guess.
And to the left.
Is just his return alone big enough, Mikey, no matter who he fights?
I mean, Floyd is Floyd. I mean, no matter who he fights, he's going to, you know, generate, you know, buzz and big fights. But between Danny and Broner, I don't see a big, big difference. I mean, Danny's undefeated, and he's holding a title at the welterweight division. You know, Broner just lost his, you know, title on the scale at 140, so he may come back at 147, maybe win a title there or something. You know?
Okay, Mayweather-Pacquiao rematch. Is that even a possibility? No?
Not for me. I mean, I don't know if the fans want to see that again. But, I mean, who knows? I mean, if Manny decides he wants to do the rematch and Floyd says, you know what, that's the next best thing. I mean, if business is better to do a rematch than to go with Floyd and Danny or Floyd and Adrian Broner, then the rematch makes more sense for both guys, and that's what they're gonna do. But I don't think I'm not interested in that.
Triple G. Oh, go ahead.
Mike, you know, as a fighter, if you were in Floyd's shoes, I mean, he had the chance to walk away undefeated, 49-0, Ty Marciano's record. As a fighter, could you walk away, or would you come back? Because he could do something a lot of fighters can't do.
I don't know if he's interested in the record that people, you know, put out there. He could easily break the record if that's something that he wants to do, because he could fight other guys and break the record and, you know, go another 5-6 fights without losing, you know, picking the right opponents. But is it something that the fans want to see? I mean, I don't know. I think he's more interested in the business. You know, it is a business, and he's, I think, more interested in that at this point of his career than any record.
But should he be scared about, you know, nobody's ever beat Father Time, nobody's undefeated against him? You know, you get old overnight. I mean, is it? Should he just come back for one and done, or do you see him having to continue even more? He's 39 years old.
Well, it depends on what he wants to do. If he wants to go for legs, and then he continues, maybe, you know, a few more fights just to fight other fighters out there. But I mean, who else is out there? I mean, he's beating everybody who was the best at their time that when he fought him. You know, right now other new guys. You mentioned Dan. You mentioned Broner. But a lot of people don't even consider them to be the best. You know, so. There's not a whole lot to prove right now against, you know, Danny or Broner. Not for Floyd, you know? Not for Floyd. For someone like myself or a younger fighter, then yeah, those are great fights. But for Floyd, it may not be the best, you know, for his legacy. Maybe just for the record.
You know what people are going to say? Like, he should come back and fight Triple G. Is that even realistic at this point? You're asking him to go even on... He's barely a natural 147, 154, 160. What do you think?
I just think, like, what for? I mean, that's why there's divisions, you know? And I mean, after that, what, you know, you fight Kovalev or something, because that's what they'll say. I mean, I've seen it, you know, people don't consider that, but they think it's so easy to just move up in weight class and for someone to drop weight class, fuck, you know, I guarantee you know, Triple G can't come to 147, you know, maybe squeeze down maybe to 154, 155, maybe, you know, but what for? He's at 160, you know? Floyd's at 147. You know, he's done it to, you know, move up to 154 twice or three times maybe, but with the right opponent at the right time. Maybe not anymore. Maybe he's older and he doesn't want to take that risk. You know, there's no need for that. That's why there's divisions.
But you're excited. It's big news. It's big. This is a boxing fan, not even as a star.
If he says he's coming back, like I said, I think anybody between 130 to 160 is going to be excited.
168 even.
You know,
you're excited because you might want to fight him, right?
Anybody wants to fight him. I mean, if he is back, you know, the best way to prove yourself is to fight the best. You know, you can compete and compare yourself, you know, and prove yourself by fighting the best. And I would say he is the best. So, of course, I would love to, you know, get in the ring with him. I mean, even if it was just as a sparring session, man, just to fucking show him what I got and to kind of see if he's really all that. I mean, still now, I mean, maybe a couple years ago, he would have slapped me around, but maybe now he won't.
So you, as a fighter, you're curious to see what it feels like to be in there with him?
I mean, before his last fight with Berto, I messaged James, hey, bro, before his training camp is over, let me know when I can go and spar him, you know, just to fucking get in there before he retires. Never happened, of course, but maybe now that chance is available.
Okay, trick question. If Mikey Garcia could fight on the Mayweather undercard, because we don't know Mayweather's fighting, who would you want to fight in September?
In September?
Yeah.
Before getting to who I want to fight or who I'm signing with, I mean, if we don't have to worry about who I'm signing with anything, okay, first, this is my plan. If I wanted to, if there was no, you know, barriers as far as promotion managers and networks and whatever, okay, come back at 140 just to get back, then come down to 35 for a title, most preferably against Flanagan, because he holds the WBO, and being that I was WBO champ twice, I need that third WBO title to get my ring.
You want that ring.
I've told you before.
I
know.
That
ring. That third WBO title gives me that ring. So Flanagan would be, that would probably be 35, obviously, maybe late in September. Then before the end of the year, maybe go back to 40, fight for a title at 40. I think there's another guy, who's fighting for the...
Postol against Crawford?
Yeah, but they're...
That's WBC?
That's BC. No, BO...
At 140?
No. That's Crawford.
Right.
No, BA.
WBA. Who's the WBA 140?
They just lost. Well, the one Broner lost. The one who's fighting for that?
Oh, it's vacant right now?
No, but they're fighting for it.
Okay, I'm not sure.
Well, whatever. I'd go with that so that I could unify with the winner of Crawford and Postol at 140. And I'm talking, like I said,
no barriers
between promoters and everything. First, get a title to unify against those two guys, right? After that, move up to 47 next year by May. Move up to 47, maybe fighting Garcia there at 47, and then you're lined up for a fight with Floyd in September next year. Right. That'd be, you know, fucking sweet scenario thing. But you gotta be realistic, you know. Well, that'd be the perfect, ideal scenario for me.
Tell all the fans where to follow you.
Team Mikey Garcia on Instagram. I'm pretty active on that. And on Twitter at Mikey Garcia, stay in touch that way.
By the way, did you hear that Jesse Vargas called out Danny Garcia? Danny said, "Let's do it. If they fight, who wins?"
I don't know. I mean, 147. I doubt that fight happens for promotional reasons or whatever, but I think Danny still takes it, but it won't be easy. I mean, Jesse showed a lot the other day, and I think he's improved a lot. He started to really let his hands go more, and he probably learned a lot from the last few fights, and I like what I see.
Who gets high more often, Snoop Dogg or High on Life?
Nah, Snoop Dogg. Uncle Snoop.
You think
That's his idol.
Uncle Snoop, he's everybody.
You think so? You can't outsmoke him?
Nah, fuck no.
All right, cookies?
I'll take him out in Madden, though.
If you could, who would you want to see Floyd? He comes back. Who would Mikey? If it's not you, who would you want to see Floyd fight?
Racing fucking challenge.
There's not a whole lot out there, like said, to prove himself. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's already done it.
And let's use a no barriers. You could just who would Mikey Garcia want to see him fight?
I think a good fight would be maybe. Let me see. I'm trying to think. I mean, there's no one out there that can say, oh, this guy's gonna test him. A good fight would be Thurman for youth, strength, natural welterweight. That'd be a good one. But I still have to favor Floyd, based on skills. But that would be pretty good. I think that's a little more competitive, maybe, or a little more interesting. Not competitive, more interesting than the Danny fight, because of the natural strength and just size. But who else could be out there?
and somebody like Errol Spence can probably.
He needs a few fights, probably. He needs a few fights to mature, but he's got the skills. He's got the skills. I like the guy, but maybe a little more fights to get that experience behind him. You take a guy like him, he may have the skills, but you don't want to rush him either against the guy like Floyd.
Ronda Rousey, Conor McGregor. They've been calling him out.
Yeah, everybody's been calling him out.
Canelo rematch?
I don't like it. I mean, I think Canelo fights Pacquiao before that, you know, Mayweather fights him again. I think Pacquiao might fight Canelo if he comes back.
Does he win?
No, but it's a good fight. And he has a good shot against him because Pacquiao still has footwork. You know, still look pretty good against Bradley. He's a little older and stuff, but that's a good fight. You know, Mexico, Philippines, and all that, you know.
Who would sell?
It's a business.
Thanks, Mike. I know you got to get to Oxnard, man. Thank you so much.